Excuse my charisma, vodka with a spritzer, swagger down pat, call my shit Patricia!
Hey guys, Mr. T-Laxify back, and in today's video, I'm coming at you guys with another zombies video, and in this one, this is going to be the top 5 ascension secrets. Now with today's video, there's going to be no particular order, and Call of the Dead secrets will be coming out for next week, but if you haven't seen my previous videos about top 5 secrets from 5 all the way back to Nocturne Tone, please go do that right now. It will make a lot more sense if you watch this video. And in today's topic about ascension, I've learned that the ascension is the story of a man named Gersh, and it also explains the huge tactic or techniques about the teleportation system in Call of Duty Zombies. We can also see some element 115 overpowering in a couple different people, and in general, ascension, if I describe it in one sort of phrase, it is the war between Richtofen and Samantha. So anyways guys, let's head on straight to our number 5 spot, and in today's video, this is going to be the fun facts of ascension. Now if you remember way back when, in my Nocturne Totem Secrets video, when I mentioned the phrase ascend to darkness, we can finally see a little bit more truth to this quote, because if you go onto the loading screen on ascension, you'll be able to find these 3 rockets standing up, and what you can see behind these rockets is their shadows, and the shadow actually spells out 115, and we obviously know element 115 was a huge sort of thing to create the zombies, create the space monkeys, which I will be talking about in a little bit of today's video. And also we know that there's a lot of haters of element 115, and speaking of the detesters or the haters of 115, Peter McCain, let's talk about him for a bit. So last week on my last episode of 5 secrets, I also forgot to mention that there is a blank portrait right beside Richtofen, and a lot of people said that this could either be Maxis or Peter McCain. And Peter McCain, as you guys know, if you have seen my Shinonuma secrets and everything, he was a big hater of 115, and his ghost sort of lingers on in Darice and stuff, and he could be present in 5 as well. It's very interesting to see that as well. We'll be talking about him more next week in the Call of the Dead secret. So I thought that was a little cool thing to add in today's video. And also, the numbers when starting up Black Ops. So when you start up Black Ops, you get this little loading screen, and there's this woman that actually says these numbers. They're totally random, but the only significance that they really have is that they represent the ties between the rocket research and Project Thunder between 5 and Ascension. Because if you guys don't know, 5 and Ascension were happening at the exact same time, and this is a big crucial part towards this Easter egg. And if you're probably wondering what the rocket research is, I'll explain that more in my number 4 spot. And also, Project Thunder was basically the reverse engineering of the Thunder Gun. And guys, the leader of this project was Gersh, the man you hear at the start whenever you play Ascension, and also his partner Yuri. So anyways guys, let's head on straight into our number 4 spot. And in this one, this is going to be the story of Yuri and Gersh. Now, Gersh was essentially the leader of all the Ascension experiments, and he was also the leader of a big project named Project Thunder. Now, in Project Thunder, guys, this was the place that they were trying to recreate the Thunder Gun, and we can also see this happening with 5. And again, this was all the Illuminati Richtofen manipulation that I mentioned last week, and we see that in full effect here in Ascension and also in 5. Now, let's go back to the story. So, Gersh was the leader of Ascension, and then you have his little partner sidekick named Yuri. Now, Yuri eventually gets crazy off of element 115, and he also gets jealous of Gersh. He's unfortunately, to his demise, transferred to the rocket research area, and this is all about the space monkeys and everything. But what he really wants to do is work on a project named Project Mercury. And Project Mercury was actually based off of the Gersh device itself, and this is the huge basis of all the teleportation in Call of Duty Zombies. And he thought his intellect was actually wasted when he was transferred into the rocket research to deal with all the space monkeys, and he even says this in a quote. Now also in this quote, he mentions something very, very peculiar. He says, "Is that a Matryoshka doll? Did someone let a child in?" And this is Samantha breaching the void into the actual real world to take over Yuri, and this is what essentially gets him crazy. He goes absolutely insane. Samantha takes a control control of them with element 115, and we can see this because of the current demise that Gersh is in when the players come in. And I'll show you guys all about this. Basically, the Matryoshka dolls sort of represent a demise. It's sort of a symbolism there for demise, and Samantha also has these little Matryoshka dolls around the map of all the characters. And unfortunately, in the end, all the characters do die except for Richtofen, which later goes on all the way into Buried, and we'll talk about that way later there. But essentially, how Yuri gets really crazy is he finds this book about 115, and on the title cover, you can see the name Edward Richtofen. We can see this book in many different other maps like 5 and Kino as well, and he becomes absolutely obsessed with the idea of element 115. Unfortunately, this clouds his mind, and he becomes controlled by Samantha, and Samantha sort of torments him in this process, and then Yuri locks Gersh into the Gersh device, most likely locking him into the ether itself with Samantha, which is really, really crazy. Also, Yuri realizes what he has done, and he just snaps out of it. He immediately regrets it, and then all is lost. We don't really know what happens to him after that. In my personal opinion, I believe Samantha just ends up killing him because she doesn't want to deal with any of his shit anymore. And basically, our characters come in at Ascension when Gersh is trapped into the ether, and he says, please free me, please free me. You gotta get me out through the Kazmir mechanism because Samantha is coming. And this is again where our four players come in. But anyways, let's head on straight into our number 3 spot. And in today's video, this is going to be the main Easter egg of Ascension, and also the very, very first really big one, the Kazmir mechanism. Now, this is the essential gateway between Earth and the Aether, and also a teleporter in itself. Now, remember what I said at the beginning of the video, that Ascension was essentially a war between Richtofen and Samantha? This Easter egg proves all that. So anyways, guys, this war started when Richtofen locked Maxis and Samantha into this sort of device with element 115, and Maxis cursed group 935's death, and this is all back in Doris. And then Maxis essentially told Samantha to go after Richtofen and the crew and to kill them all and to finish them off. Now, unfortunately, the battleground does involve Yuri and Gersh, which is really sad to see that both of them, I'll tell you guys right now, end up being into their demise. They both essentially die, and it's very weird because this is one of the only big Easter eggs in Call of Duty Zombies itself that actually doesn't get an achievement, which is very surprising because it's probably more major than a lot of the Easter eggs. I'd even say the one in Call of the Dead as well. It's a big part into how Samantha and Richtofen react to each other, and it's very, very important towards the whole storyline. But anyways, let's talk about the parts in the Easter egg. So in the Easter egg, you have to throw these Gersh devices at the outside parts of the map, at these sort of toaster little oven looking things, and they're so big and it's just kind of weird. And what's really cool is once you figure out what these things are by listening to different radios, you'll actually learn that this is a first node or part of the Kazmir mechanism, which is very, very cool, and I thought that was really awesome. And also, when you go to initiate the first node in the Easter egg and you hold X on a certain computer, the Illuminati symbol shows up, and this is a very key part to actually the whole thing because this confirms my 5 theory about Illuminati and Richtofen's control against this whole situation in Russia and also in America, and I thought that was really cool to see. Now, after you get the second node and the third node in the Easter egg, you gotta get the fourth node. And the fourth node, basically, it's really cool. You're in this Ascension Lunar Lander, and you fly around getting these letters in the sky. And these letters actually end up spelling the word Luna, which in many different languages means moon. And again, this is another correlation to the moon Easter egg, which I will talk about in that secrets video. But also, once you do all the four nodes and you get all the way up to the last step, you have to power the Kazmir mechanism, and this requires a ton of stuff. You need like the upgraded thunder gun, upgraded ray guns, and you just need a lot of stuff to get this working, and it's probably one of the harder steps in the Easter egg. But anyways, the players actually end up, or the crew actually end up, giving the Kazmir mechanism too much power, which then sends them to Siberia, or also known as Call of the Dead, and we'll talk about that more in the next week's video. And also, what's really cool is that when you finish this Easter egg, you get a death machine, and the death machine is actually very symbolic. in this way, because the Death Machine only appears with Easter eggs that involve the Gersh device. So this only appears on Ascension, and it also only appears on Moon. And the Death Machine, in my eyes, represents freedom, escape, or power, because the Death Machine also is always used for when people get out of the ether. So for example, in Ascension, it's used for when Gersh comes out of the ether, and Moon, it's used when Samantha comes and switches bodies with Richtofen, which is a very cool little link that I found there. And also, what's a really cool thing to see is that in Dead Ops Arcade, to get the Death Machine, you have to actually go into the room called the Fate of Power. And when you get the Death Machine, it's represented as a huge amount of power. And as again, we can see this in the Moon Easter egg, all that cool stuff. But whatever. After completing this Easter egg, though, Dempsey says something very, very particular that really caught my eye. And he says, "I don't know if this was a good idea letting Gersh out." And when you realize what he said, you're like, oh my goodness, that might not be a great idea, because Gersh says that he's free when he escapes, but is he actually free? Because as you're activating the nodes and as you're getting closer to finishing the Easter egg, Gersh says that Samantha is getting closer, and we don't know that in this particular time that perhaps Samantha brainwashed Gersh, and in the end Samantha kills Gersh. This is particularly what I think, because why would Samantha just leave Gersh and Yuri alive? It doesn't really make sense. So I personally believe that he was potentially possessed, and then he was able to just kill himself from there. So it's really sad to see that Yuri and Gersh are victims of this war, and it's really sad to see that this has to end up in so many lives later that get killed. But what also is pretty weird to see is that if you listen very quietly once you finish the Ascension Easter egg, Samantha says, "Come find me," very, very quietly. And again, this relates to the Moon Easter egg when the crew finds Samantha in the Moon, which is really cool. And also, I believe that the Kazmir mechanism is shown to be the way Samantha travels to torment Yuri. And this brings us to our number two spot, and this is going to be about the Space Monkeys. Now, the Space Monkeys were made by Yuri, and when Yuri was in his rocket research area in the Ascension group, this explains why when the monkeys come down, they crash down on lunar landers, which is very interesting to say as well. We also learn in Ascension that monkeys are actually stronger than humans when they are overcome by element 115. We can see this by the cosmic silverback and also in Shangri-La with the monkeys, because they look a lot more grotesque and they're very, very powerful, particularly in this map. Let me give you some examples. The first one is that they're resistant to the thunder gun, the Gersh device, claymores, and grenades, and they're also very, very smart. And once you are finally actually able to kill them, they release this huge red impulse of element 115, showing that they've just been absolutely wrecked by element 115, and it's really ridiculous. And the reason why they actually go for your perks is because they are in need of more power. They're just sort of urged by the sense of getting more power, and this is what also causes them to just be absolutely crazy. And also, they want to inhibit you. They're smart, they're monkeys, they hate humans, obviously. And this also shows that 5 and Ascension were working together on this project, because in 5 you can see a lot of monkey cages, and also on Ascension you can just see the space monkeys. And also, there's a lot of storage tanks in Ascension that shows a ton of radiation, and it's just a lot of these testing grounds that Yuri was using as well, and it's very, very interesting to find. What's also cool about the radiation evidence that I found is that on the Ascension poster itself, you can look at Richtofen and you can see that he doesn't actually have any hair, and this could possibly be a reasoning to radiation, or just of him going absolutely insane, and I thought that was really cool. And also, you can find that Treyarch, after a little while, once the maps was initially released, they actually changed the thumbnail of the map to look more staticky and to represent a more radiation look or feel. But anyways, guys, let's head down straight into our number one spot. And in this one, this is going to be the aftermath. Now, we essentially know what happened with the crew, but what really happened with 5? Obviously, they were both happening at the same time, so it's very interesting, and let's figure this out. So obviously, on Ascension, there's the exact same red telephones as there are in 5, and when answered, you could actually hear the 5 characters in Ascension saying their quotes like Kennedy, and it's really, really cool to see that. And in the end, the Kazmir mechanism being repaired is really bad, because this essentially means that of course Gersh was able to be freed, but we don't know if he's actually still alive. And also, this means that Richtofen got power of Project Mercury, or the Gersh device, and he used this for the Five with the Illuminati. He was able to transport, because the whole point of being from Ascension to Five was the transportation system. And basically, Richtofen took control of that, and he left with it, and he's basically going to use this power for himself. And we can see this very later on in Transit, when he's able to transport the whole of Nocturne Toten into Transit, into America, which is really, really cool. And we can also see that the zombies, crawlers, and the monkeys were actually originated from Five, and the teleportation system, or the Gersh device, actually brought the zombies into Ascension, which is a really cool thing, a little bit about that. And also, we can confirm that Richtofen was able to freely use the Gersh device, because on Moon, once he finally takes control over the zombies, he says that he'll show Gersh how to properly build a Gersh device, which is really, really cool in that sense as well. And also, one last thing before I end the video is that the background song, or the main Easter egg song on Ascension, is Abracadabra. And in the end, it shows the good and bad of Samantha, which is the reasons why we see the Reapers on the wall in Ascension, in Kino, in Five. We can see them all. And in the end, guys, if you're having a bad time,
reach for vodka tonight.
Anyways, guys, I do hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please make sure to drop a like for the next Top 5 Call of the Dead Secrets video. Again, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.